DC motors have been around for more than 140 years, and they are still used today. Before we get started, if you want to support us, don't forget to leave a like at this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. This type of motor is a rotary electrical device, which converts electrical power into mechanical power. It was the first widely used since it could be powered from existing direct current lightning power distribution systems. There's no better way to understand the functioning of a DC motor by building one. No, I'm not kidding. In this video, you can learn how to build a simple version of a DC motor with the everyday life materials, such as a syringe, an iron rod which we had previously cut from an old clothes hanger, .25 mm copper wire, 1.5 mm copper wire, some screws, 4 hole angled brackets, some glue, 2 magnets, a power supply, in this case a battery's holder with cables and clamps. Let's start removing the plunger from the syringe in this way. Let's make sure that the iron rod is perfectly sliding into our syringe. Now, let's take a tiny piece of plastic and let's make a hole in the middle of it, in this way. The diameter of the hole must allow the iron rod to well slide into it. Now, we can glue our piece of plastic on the syringe. Our hole must be perfectly centered. When the glue is dry, we can remove the excess plastic in this way. Now, with a marker, we draw the points where we will drill our syringe. We will create 8 rows of dots. Each row must have 6 dots. Let's make sure that the distance between rows and dots are equal. Now, we can make the holes. Let's put the screws inside the holes using a screwdriver. Now that we've set up all the screws, let's take our 1.5 mm copper wire to shape small pieces of it in this way. we have to cut and shape 8 small pieces of copper. We're going to remove the isolation layer of the copper on the points where we will weld. Now, we can glue the small shaped pieces of copper over every single row of screws. When the glue is completely dried, we can wrap our 0.25mm copper wire. This step is essential for the functioning of our engine. In fact, we're going to create the poles of the motor by wrapping the copper wire around the screws. So, it's necessary to wrap the wire counterclockwise for 100 times around every single row of screws, keeping in mind what is the input wire and what is the output wire on each row of screws. We can compact each coil in this way. Moving on with the winding. This is the final result. Now, we unravel every single input wire and every single output wire in this way. Even at this stage, we are going to remove the isolation layer of the copper on the points where we will weld. Again, this step is essential for the functioning of our engine. We have to wrap the input wires of each row, not around their upper copper angle bracket, but around the next bracket on their left, creating a 90 degrees angle. This is what we need to get. Now, we also have to wrap the output wires of each row, not around their upper copper angle bracket, but around the third bracket on the right, creating a 90 degrees angle. This is what we need to get. Okay, now we can weld every single wire's terminal on the copper angle brackets. this is the final result. Now, let's shape two tiny plastic circles with a central hole like this one. And we paste it over the copper angled bracket, in this way. We're doing this to isolate the copper. Let's take our two metal angled brackets and we follow this procedure to reduce its old diameters to the iron rod diameter. Now we can build the support for our DC motor in this way. We previously shaped this 1.5 mm copper wire in this way to create what can be considered the brushes of our DC motor, which are responsible for the transmission of the power to the copper angled brackets and consequently to the copper coils. Okay, now we can fix our brushes in this way. We have to follow this procedure. To be sure that our brushes touch in the copper angled brackets in this way. Now we can also fix two more brackets in this way, where we're going to place our two magnets. So, our DC motor is ready to be tested. Let's take our power supply and we plug the clamps on the brushes of our DC motor. It works! Our engine starts to rotate. If we try to plug the clamps in the other way, our DC motor changes rotation. When the electricity flows through the coils, an electromagnetic field is created. This means that the electricity has temporarily turned coils into a magnet. In this scheme, the upper coil represents our north pole, so it will be attracted to the south pole of the magnet on the right. On the contrary, the lower coil represents our south pole, so it will be attracted to the north pole of the magnet on the left, allowing a clockwise motion of our DC motor. Finally, if you found this video useful, let us know by leaving a comment and subscribing to our YouTube channel to stay tuned on the release of new videos. Thanks for watching.